Hi, welcome to ESP32 tutorial from RoboJax. My name is Ahmed Shamshiri. I'm presenting this tutorial from Canada. In this tutorial, we're going to learn how we can control two DC motors using ESP32 and L298N module. And here now the demonstration, it shows motor one goes at clockwise. This is just a test of motor one. And here is the demonstration of controlling two motors. As you can see, two motor brake. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/arduino. Let's get started with this. Controlling a DC motor, controlling DC motors require H bridge. If you want to use a chip, something like this, L298N. This is a dual H bridge module, which means that with one H bridge you can control fully a DC motor in clockwise, counterclockwise, and also with another H bridge you can control the second one. So that's why this is a dual H bridge. And when you want to control a DC motor using Arduino, it's very straightforward, much easier. But with ESP32, because we are able to change the frequency, the bitrate, and selecting different channels for the purpose, each can be configured, so it's not straightforward with ESP32. And ESP32 has a library for controlling the intensity of light of LEDs. Now I'm using the same library that I have written for this for Arduino. Now we are using it for ESP32 to control the speed of this motor in this tutorial. Separate video explaining full functionality, features, datasheet, and specification of this module. You can use it easily with Arduino. The link will be available below this video. Separate video explaining how you can get started with ESP32. And I have two videos, just short video to be able to get started. The other is full details of this. The link will be below this video. In this module, in L298N module, we connect one motor at this port. This is motor one. This is connected to this point. And the motor two, this wire is connected at this point. We have three terminals here. This is the positive. You will connect your external power. These two wires are for external power. You connect your power here. If your motor is 12 volts, connect 12 volts. If it's 6, connect 6 volts, and so forth. Up to 35 volts can be connected here. And this is a 5 volts regulator, which outputs from this point a 5 volts at the third terminal. From here also, you can supply this 5 volts back to your ESP32 or any other module that you have. Now, in terms of power for a smart car or for other purposes that you have, you might have, instead of one motor, two motor on the left side and then two motors here. So you will have four motors, but the two motor on the left side can be connected in parallel. So this is one motor. You will connect another motor also at this point, and also two motors can be connected in parallel in here. So in terms of power, this can handle 2 ampere continuously on this channel and 2 ampere continuously on this channel. So if your motors each consume 1 ampere, then you will be good, because two of them will be 2 ampere on this side and 2 on this side. So, and that's one of the major question and concern of people who are using it, because if you don't know the power, this module will die if you overload it with this heatsink. And if you replace this heatsink with a larger one, this can handle about 2.5 ampere continuous current. Now let me explain the wiring. We will connect motor one at this point. The polarity doesn't matter, because it will rotate either clockwise or counterclockwise. The other will be connected, the second motor will be connected to this point. And you will connect your external power at these two points. This point from the ground, you will connect one more wire to the ground, to one of the ground of ESP32, because it has multiple ground. This is one of the ground that I'm using. And once the programming is done, once you disconnect USB from here, from this 5 volts, you can connect the 5 volts to ESP32 V5 to ESP32 V5 or 5 volts pen. I've explained it in a separate video how to use the 5 volts of this. Make sure to watch that. The link is below this video. For this module, we have enable A and input 1, input 2. These two are for the first motor on that side. And this is input 3, input 4. And the last one is enable B. This enable is where we feed the pulse modulation signal for the motor 2. And this is pulse modulation pin for motor 1. And I've used here, I'm using all these pins in a sequence so you don't make in terms of wiring any mistake. And I've started here from pin 19, 18, pin 5, 17, and 16. And enable A is connected to pin 19. And then input 1, input 2 are connected to pin 18 and 5. And input 3 and 4 are connected to 17 and 16, and enable B is connected to pin 4 at this point. And as you can see, they are all and they are arranged like this. In order to start using ESP32 with Arduino IDE, you need to prepare Arduino IDE for that purpose. You will copy and paste it here. You see it says package esp32index.json at the end. So once you paste it here, click OK, click OK. This is telling Arduino IDE where to get the board driver. Click on Tools, and then Boards, Board Manager. And here, wait for this to complete at the bottom, this bar graph. And then type here ESP32. You see ESP32 by Espressif Systems. It says installed. In your case, it will not be installed. You will have install button here. Click on it, and it will take maybe a few seconds or a minute. And the installation, once is completed, click close. Now we have to tell Arduino IDE which board you're working with, because the driver is ready. Click on Tool, Boards. This is Arduino IDE, which you will usually work, but scroll down until you see a line below that. All of these are ESP32, and ESP32 Rover module is the one that you click and select, and the dot will appear. Now we have to select the port. For that, we have to find out which port we are using. Right click on the start menu, device manager, and you see port. Click on this arrow to collapse it, and mine is using COM port, Silicon Lab. If I disconnect it now, you will see that it will disappear. Connecting it back. So this is COM6. Note that, click on Tool, Ports, and you will see COM6 is already selected. And now you can write your program and run it. Let me now explain the code. I've written library for L298N. This library is working with ESP32 and Arduino. I will provide you the link as a zip file. You download it in your computer and save it as zip. After that, click on Sketch, Include Library, go to add.zip library, and then browse to where you have saved it. For example, in your PC, if it was saved inside download, go and find it. For example, if this was your zip file for the library, select it and click open. After that, close Arduino, and you see I have two instances. Close them all and then reopen it. The reason for that is that you will be able to see the list after you close it, because Arduino will not show it. Once you reopen it, click on File, Example, and scroll down until you will see RoboJacks ESP-L298N DC motor. And I have two sketch here. One is DC single motor, one is DC two motors. Select DC single motor and open it. This is the file. This line, include RoboJacks L298N DC.h. This is part of the library, which will include the library. And then we are defining channel for the pulse width modulation control attached to the LEDC portion of ESP32. So we have to use one of the 16 channels. So we are using only two channels here, channel 0 for motor 1. And then these three pins are for the module enable A, N1 and 2. And I have defined these pins accordingly how they appear on the board, so you don't make mistake. Of course, you can change it if you wish. And then this CCW and CW are defined as a constant variables, and they're used inside the library. Do not change it. And here we define motor 1, and if you want to put some other word, that's fine, but make sure that the number 1 must refer to motor 1. If you have robot, let's say left arm or some portion of something, put some word here, but this should be 1, and then the other one should be 2. And here we are creating an instance of the class, and we call it motor, or you can call it robot. And then we pass these values that we have defined here, all of these 4. We pass in 1 and 2, enable A, channel A. And this true, if you want to see the debugging information, if the true is here, you will be able to see the debugging information. It shows the motor, the pen, the duty, and for debugging, but you don't need it for real world application. Otherwise, just delete that with a comma, and then we have 3-4 values separated with 3 commas. And then it will just, when this runs, we open serial monitor, there will not be anything. So we create this object, which is an instance of this class, which we will use it later on inside the code. And inside the setup, we have serial.begin. This is the baud rate of the serial monitor. When you click on tools, serial monitor, the value that you see on the right side lower corner is the one that is printed. If you select this with the wrong value, you will not be able to see the text here. Either you will see strange characters or you don't see anything. You see, you will see something like that. So otherwise, change it accordingly. And then this name you put, you must put it here with the dot begin. This will initialize with those pins the library for the motor. And then here motor.demo, if you want to demonstrate and see all the functionality of different tests, uncomment this like that, and then this will run a demonstration which is available inside the library. I'm not going to run it. So here is how you can control your motor. You type motor.rotate and then motor 1, which you defined above. And then this 60 means 60% of the speed, and CW means clockwise. And this will run the motor 1 at 60% in clockwise direction for 3 seconds, and then motor.brake 1. This motor 1 will brake for 2 seconds. So if you want motor 2 to brake, just change this to 2. And here motor 1 rotates 100% clockwise, and this is a loop that I changes from 0 to 100, and here we are changing the I 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 100, so the motor will speed up slowly, and in between we give it 100 milliseconds so the motor can move or slowly increase the speed. So as simple as this, you can control the motor with this code. I have done a lot of different tests here. And now if we go to example and then open the two motors, this is the code. I've defined 4 pins for motor 1, 4 parameters, which is 3 pin. Channel A is internal, it's not a pin. And this is for motor 2, these pins. And then here we have defined for the second motor. And here, this time we are passing N1, as you can see, N1 and 2 enable A. This is for one motor, including the channel. 4 parameters and 4 here for channel B. And if you want the same thing, 4 for one motor, 4 for the second motor, and then put through at the end to read the values. And then here I've defined them, I call it robot. As you can see, robot.begin. And here robot.rotate, motor 1, motor 2 at these speeds, which I'm going to demonstrate it next. And the loop will continuously do the same thing over and over again. And here now the demonstration, it shows motor 1 goes at clockwise. This is just a test of motor 1. Now it's 100%, and as you can see it slowly increases. This motor will start rotating at 50%. And then when it breaks, also it shows a break and then change the direction. Now it's at 60% as you can see, and stopped. And here is the number, it increases. And here is the demonstration of controlling two motors. As you can see, two motor brake. One motor is now running. And as you can see, this first motor will start rotating. Now motor one, it shows here. Motor one braked, and then now motor two will speed up slowly until it reaches some threshold value. Now both motors are running, one is clockwise, the other is counterclockwise, and stop. So this was the code 2 of demonstration of controlling two motors. And here's a demonstration using it without USB. And I will connect here my power supply. And it must be around 7 volts in order to get 5 volts regulated for this. So 7 volts enters and then you will have 5 volts here. And I've connected the 5 volts to the V5 of this module. I've separate video explaining that, so I'm not gonna spend time on that. So this, it says V5 and I'm connecting it at this pin. And also the ground is also connected to this pin, this brown wire. And as you can see, as soon as I connect it, the demonstration is now running. Thank you for watching the tutorial from RoboJax. If you like this video and learned something, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. If you want to get updates of my upcoming videos, make sure to subscribe.